Let us consider frost. Now, in order to get frost, let us pretend this is our ground level. And, well, I don't know, we have some plants or something. Now, in order for there to be frost, there must be an increase in the atmosphere's temperature. It must reach a certain amount of warmth and a certain temperature of warmth. And so this is, well, let's not even complicate things. Let us just keep in mind that this has to be, well, let's put warm. Warm temp, and this is the atmosphere. And the ground has to actually be, in some cases, it could be below freezing, or at least below the temperature needed to freeze H2O, to freeze water. And what happens, and this is a really quick process, it happens right before sunrise, which is the coldest part of either day or night. And what happens is that temperatures rise in the atmosphere, and if the case be that the Earth is below freezing, or below the temperature needed to freeze water, then the vapor being produced by the warmth, if it's enough to create a frost, then it will, because of the high temperatures and the below freezing and the sweating taking place on the plant. And so, and it happens really quick. It start. I mean, you could see it. You could pretty much go out there with a flashlight, and from 1 minute to the next, you just start seeing freezing taking place. And it's really interesting. But why we are mentioning this, and more in more detail, how does it come to pass? We have here. Let us pretend this is planet Earth. Now, we are in a cycle, and the sun is not, it doesn't go to sleep, the sun doesn't turn off. The rotation of the Earth actually makes it appear as if the sun is no longer visible, but it's still there, right? And so at dawn, right before sunrise, we are barely making that turn. And what's taking place is that the sun is always shining bright. And the increase in atmosphere temperature, let us just put atmosphere just in case. The increase of the atmosphere's temperature is due to the light and warmth and energy of the sun already impacting us here upon Earth. See, we are barely going to make that turn, but the sun is already there. So there is already an energy of light and thus warmth. Warming, or yeah, increasing the temperature of the atmosphere. But the ground is still not exposed to the sunlight. And so the ground, if the case be that it is below freezing, the plants start to sweat, and if there's enough vapor, of course, and it'll freeze really quick. Basically, why are we saying this? Well, the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. Basically, there is dawn, there's no light, well, there's no visible light, but the light and energy and warmth is already present, but the darkness comprehended it not. And so what takes place, those that comprehend not the light, they are instantly frozen. not only psychologically in this case, but physically, and loss of life. Basically, like there is no more movement in the molecule system of that which was once some kind of water. It was empty, and so now it's frozen, stiff. You know, it no movement, no heat, no energy. And that is kind of like a really elementary explanation of this, being that we personally don't know all that much about it, but it does lead us to a better understanding as to how something that is frozen, the molecules have no movement. They're just there, and so pretty much dead. But here's the good thing, and here is the good news, the wangale to all those willing and able to receive. The sun cometh around and lighted up the world, and all frost and all ice always melts, you know, and it allows for an opportunity to change and to get thyself right with the Most High God, Jah-Rastafari. You know, so there is always an opportunity. Every day is another day and another opportunity to make our to walk right in the sight of the Almighty. And that, if anything, I mean, that is the most important thing. Even the darkness that comprehended not the light gets an opportunity. So this could go along with the repentance. I mean, repent, it's the grace of the Almighty is beyond comprehension. So, and this has to do with, we'll get into that right now.
Welcome, fellow Rastafari. Now, the reason we had to include that clip was to go on to share with all the iThem these images that we've just recently captured now or taken. Now, we've been working the plantations. We just begun harvesting, and these planes, and we're gonna call it chemtrails, but although evidence points to them being so, we ourselves personally have no idea what it is that these planes are spraying. It's obvious, it's only obvious that they are spraying something, but we've never seen the gallons, the barrels. I mean, we're not just going to say stuff to say stuff. I mean, we're gonna speak that which we know. So basically, I guess it is worthy to make mention. We're not trying to scare anyone. We're not causing terror. You know, like far from that. We're just sharing what's happening, and what's happening is that this last week, the last week in particular, has been non-stop spraying. I mean, all day, every day, and large amounts. And we're not talking about two planes like we did last time, one after another. And they seem to be doing some X's, and I mean, just look at the pictures. And this isn't all of it, you know. This is what little that low budget phone I have can do, you know. I mean, there's pretty much no other way except probably recording the skies, but yeah, we're not gonna do that. So just, I mean, these pictures are kind of should give ones an idea of that. This is really taking place, like and especially here in Southern California, where it is an agricultural, I guess, like center or something. This for the last week, it has been happening, in abundance, you know. And well, let us make mention that every time we take pictures, it's no surprise that we get unidentified objects. And it's not to say aliens, it's exactly what we just said, unidentified objects. It could be a baseball for all we know, you know, but it's unidentified. That's so don't I mean, don't get confused. Don't This is not to support chemical death theories or UFO aliens and stuff like that. No, far from that. We just this is us bringing forth our report. Now, I mean, just these pictures are pretty interesting in themselves, and it would be recommended that one's kind of pause it and really take a look at them. For instance, this one in particular, there that white thing that seems to be like a tabernacle in a sense, a tent, way down in on the horizon, that's actually a cloud. And all throughout the mountains surrounding this valley, this depression was really cloudy, especially San Diego. And whatever it is that they spray, within some time, they reach really low altitudes. We tried taking a picture of a bird to give reference, but we don't know what happened. I guess we didn't take the picture, or it didn't come out all that well. But nonetheless, the reason that, oh, and this picture in particular is kind of interesting, because we've seen those objects before. One looks like Saturn, and the other one looks, I guess, whether it be electricity, a light ball, or whatever it is. But we've seen these before in many pictures, and the one that looks like Saturn, it's not Saturn, definitely. Or I could be wrong, right? But they're way too close. And well, basically, let us go on forward to the main point. Now, the reason we brought up the whole that intro video clip is because we think that at least in the Imperial Valley, south border, Southern California, we think that they're manipulating weather. Not so much spraying us to kill us or whatever. We don't think that they're that dumb. They would rather kind of like have us still be alive and do all the work that they don't want to do. So yeah, we're not sure if, I mean, we're not even gonna consider what it is that they spray. But in this case, in the Imperial Valley, from being that it's harvest time and it's winter, and well, at least it should be getting colder, and all this, like the abundant spraying and how it's out of control and increasing every day. And we noticed that after a while, it seems like if the clouds were at a really low altitude, but rather it is all that which they have sprayed, right? But we're thinking, we're gonna put this assumption, idea, opinion out there. We think that they're manipulating weather in that sense to keep the plants from frosting or something like that. I mean, even if it has nothing to do with it's a, I think it's a better comparison or point of view to just scaring people to death, by saying that these chemicals are gonna do this and that. I mean, at least this sounds a little logical, and it's not to say that they're not spraying to kill. It wouldn't surprise us, but until we actually personally, know it to be true, then until then we will not just lie to the public as many oftentimes do. So basically, that's it. I mean, we just wanted to present that. Not that this is healthy or anything, but I guess, like, more importantly, to kind of like do away with that idea of having to manufacture like harp system material or harp system technologies, whatever. I mean, we just found out that it's not that difficult to manipulate weather. I mean, it's as simple as changing temperatures in certain locations, whether it be in atmospheres or on Earth, and doing that correctly is enough to spark whatever it is that they wanna, spark up, whether it be a storm, whether it be, they want the, they have a wedding the next day and they want it to be nice and sunny, whatever it be. This kind of helped us understand that it's not as difficult, as complicated to manipulate weather. And an example would be your air conditioning at homes, if ones have one. How is that possible? It's not that hard, right? So just, it's just like I guess, like something to think about. For those that don't believe weather manipulation is possible, we think it is, and we think that that is it, in fact, what's taking place. You see, a lot of agriculture happens in this area, and a lot of white, rich, powerful people would lose a lot of money if it got too cold at a certain time. And so we'll leave all with that. We just wanted to share that bit of information that we've been able to receive. So we give thanks to all. Shalom. Rastafari.